What's going on, everyone? Enzo here, team driver for Team Associated, and today I want to make a video to go over the new Team Associated B6.4. As you guys saw, for those of you that follow my channel, I had a unboxing video on my B6.4, and now that I've had a little bit of time under the car and have been able to do a couple track days with it, I wanted to kind of go over the entire car, go over some of the equipment that I use in my personal car, and talk about some of the changes that they've done, along with kind of comparing back to my old car and how it's been a drastic benefit with everything that they've done with the new car. So let's go ahead and take the body off and we'll get started. So starting with the body off, the first thing I guess we should talk about is the new body. So Team Associate did go ahead and change and update the body design with the new B6.4. You get a much more cab forward design. The cab's definitely pushed up towards the front of the car. And you also get more so of an inspired fin. This kind of makes me remember of the J Concepts P2 body, the high downforce body that they have that has the fin. The B6.3 body had a very small fin, but it looks like they ended up going with a much more elongated fin down the backside of the spine. It has some elevated rear pod section where your motor and slipper assembly are. This helps with stability and downforce in the high speed sections. You also get a really designed pushed in side pod. The side pod of the body, if you look at it from the front, is kind of recessed inward. Kind of has a straight line and kind of pushes into the body before you have an elevated step, just like the back. So what I've noticed when comparing to the old kit body, which I did do, is I put the old stock body on the new car and then compared it with this one, is that these recessed pod areas both here and in the back of the body definitely give it a lot more stability in the high speed areas, and along with that, a lot more on power steering for the front. I do notice that the body reacts a little bit better to steering input at the end of the straightaway and the sweepers and a lot of the sections where you are already going quick and a lot of air is hitting that body. So definitely a noticeable improvement with corner speed and stability. Specifically, I notice it more in the modified classes. All I run is mod. I have driven a couple buddies B6.4s that do run stock, and the kit body versus the new body in the stock classes is a little bit more of an improvement. I wouldn't say as noticeable as the mod classes, just due to how much quicker you're going. So that's it for the body. Now we'll actually get into the car. All right, now that we're actually talking about the car, one of the big changes that they did for this year is they actually played with the entire weight bias of the car and pushed everything forward. Your motor, your battery, your speedo are all shifted forward a couple millimeters in comparison to your old car. The speedo and battery are definitely shifted forward, I'd say more than 3 millimeters. So it's pretty crazy how big the weight change is when you compare it side by side to the old car. Looking at it right now, for most of you guys watching this video, it will look very similar to the old car, but if you do have the chance to compare it to your old car side by side, you will notice a really big difference in how they shifted everything forward. So that's definitely a big improvement on the track. A lot more stability on exit, on corners. There's less of a swing weight effect in the back of the car just because of everything being pushed forward. So stability's definitely improved. I'd say your steering going in and out of corners off power is definitely improved because you have more weight bias towards the front of the car. So definitely a big improvement there. The second biggest improvement that they did, and the second biggest change I think they did aside from the chassis that we'll keep talking about, is the new 13 millimeter shocks. These are bigger in diameter than the old shocks. We'll compare right here with my four-wheel drive. These are the 12 millimeter Kashima code shocks that I have on my B74. And if we compare to the two-wheel, they are definitely bigger. So these are the new 13 mil shocks. that Associated has gone out and installed on the new B6.4. With the new shocks, Associated did drop a new revised line of 13 mil springs. So there is a new spring line that you'll have to update yourself to run the new car if you want to have the tunability. The good thing is, for those of you guys that are coming from a past Associated model and you have a lot of spare parts or shock shafts and stuff like that, is all of your internals, your shock O-rings, your shock shafts, your shock inserts, your Delrin machined inserts, the low friction rings, all of the internals on the shocks from the 12 millimeter will transfer over to the new shocks, with the exception of obviously the shock body, the shock cap, and the piston. Everything else does transfer over to the new shock. So if you have chrome shock shafts, you have a ton of packs of low friction X rings and machined inserts, all of that stuff will transfer over. So the only thing, like I said, that changes is the body, the cap, and the piston. Moving on, after the shocks, sorry for the noise. The arms are the same, which is nice. The arms are the same. I do run the factory team carbon hard front arms. This helps give it a little bit more responsiveness going in, but once the weight's on the front of the car in the corner, it actually calms the front of the car down. On the super high grip tracks that we run on, I've liked running the hard front arms. Just keeps the front of the car calm. Now, another change that they did is they removed the outer hole on the front bulkhead. So the front ball stud mount is now only a two-hole design. Just a little bit more simplified. They give you the two most common options that we use. Another big change on the B6.4 is the revised scrub radius and angle that they did. They did a minus one kingpin scrub angle is what they did to the front of the car. So they revised the caster blocks and the spindles on the new design. And what this does is it plays all in tow with the new chassis design and the lowered front kickup angle that they have. Going off of the B6.3 chassis, the B6.3 chassis had a more drastic angle of front kickup, whereas on the new B6.4, they actually removed kickup from the chassis, so you have a flatter front end. And to go along with that change, they went ahead and revised the front caster blocks and spindles to all, in a sense, add off one another and go together with the changes. They also gave us a new aluminum front kickup block. This is a 0 degree. They have a new 0 degree option. For those of you that have the old front aluminum kickup block, it will bolt onto the car and will still work on the new B6.4. So that's good to know for the guys that are running the old car with a lot of these hop-ups. Along with some of the steering changes, they went ahead and updated the steering bell crank system, and now they give you the option, if you can see it, on top of the steering bell cranks, there is a small shim, which now you can raise and lower your steering bell cranks in the entire steering assembly when you run a certain degree of caster. And they do this so you can get the right amount of bump steer with the front of the car, depending on the caster insert and the kickup angle that you run. There is a little chart in the manual when you are building the car that kind of breaks this down for you and explains it to you so you know what insert to run. Currently, I am on kit settings for my front caster and kickup block and all of that. So again, there is a chart in the manual that will explain when to run it high or low, depending on how much kickup you run and what caster insert you run. So that's it for that. The front tower is the same. The front tower guard, basically all of that is right off of the B6.3. Let's see what else. Oh, and then back to the chassis. The chassis, along with being pushed forward and a lot of the things being shifted forward for the better weight bias, it is wider now. And that's another reason why the old body doesn't fit as good on the new car, is because the new car is wider. Definitely, I think for those of you guys that run the B6.3, this should be a noticeable improvement right off the rip. And instantly you can tell that the car is different from looking at it from the bottom. Totally wider design. I will say the new car with the box setup for the B6.4 is pretty money. It's very stable, generates a ton of grip. And for those guys with most conditions being that medium to high grip indoor clay for the dirt tracks around the country, the kit setup will be very close. I personally, because we run on a sealed glued track, I have gone ahead and went to the plus 3 carpet chassis, just like I did on the old car. In mod, I feel like I prefer a very stable car, but still has a lot of that high speed rotation, and the long chassis definitely offers that to you when you run modified with the longer chassis. So I did go ahead and do the carpet chassis on the dirt car. And then aside from that, moving towards the rear of the car, I am doing the B6.3 rear end setup. So the pivot blocks, the arms, the plus 2 ball stud mount, the hubs, the entire rear end of the car is the same exact parts and part numbers as the B6.3. So if you have a lot of replacement parts, arms, these pivot blocks, you have the plus 2 ball stud mounts. A lot of these parts will carry over from your old car. And the good thing, like I said, is that the entire rear end is the same car. So currently I do have the standard material. So the soft kit plastic type material, 75 rear arms. The kit does come with 73. I'm running the 75 millimeter arms with the narrow pivot, which is a setup option that a lot of us did on the B6.3. Just something that I like doing. Again, we run on a super high grip, sealed glued track, so the traction's very high. And it's just one of the things that I like to do when the grip gets like that, or we go to tracks where it's very high grip, is having that wider rear arm. It kind of stabilizes the car under power, under acceleration, and at the same time gives a little bit more rotation in the high speed sections. And even the slower corners from middle to exit. So this is a preference thing, but again, the kit setup with the 73 arms and the short chassis is really good out of the box for, I'd say, 80 to 90% of the tracks around the country. This is just something that I do for my driving style and a few things that I've done to suit my personal track conditions since we run on a very high grip indoor clay. In terms of hop-ups, the car honestly doesn't even have that many hop-ups. I carried over my plus 2 ball stud mount. I'll go ahead and put the part number to that. The plus 2 ball stud mount, I do have the carbon fiber factory team servo brace right here. And then aside from that, I have the hard front arms. That is an option, really. That's not really something that I would even say is needed. All of these things I'll put the part number to. I have the wide rear arms, the 75 rear arms, and the last thing would be the aluminum 0-degree front kick-up block, which you guys see right there. So that's really it in terms of hop-ups. I don't really have any special parts on this car, or it's not really outfitted with too many, special things. It's just what I just mentioned. And then if you maybe want to consider it a must, which some people I've seen run stock internals perfectly fine, is the machine shock inserts, just to make the shocks a little bit smoother. But aside from that, that's all the hop-ups the car really has. The rest of it is just bling things that I like to do so it looks cool. For example, the screw kit, that's just something that I do so the car looks a little bit neat. I got these pretty dialed J-Concepts wing buttons that are the finisher line wing buttons, which are pretty cool. They kind of go with the whole paint. But aside from that, like I said, it's super basic. Not that many hop-ups on the car. The car basically works right out of the gate. And I guess now we'll go into some of the electronics that I opted to use on my B6.4. So starting off for the servo, I am running the Reedy 1705A low-profile servo. It's an all-aluminum servo. Pretty dialed. I really like it a lot. Very smooth. Perfect for two-wheel drive. Kind of gets the job done. As for power, same as always, I run the Muchmore systems. I have the Flata Pro V2 ESC from Muchmore, the Muchmore Impact 4500 7.6 volt shorty pack. Then I have the Muchmore Racing Flata ZX V2 8.5 turn. I like running an 8.5 in mod. I know some guys like to run a 7.5, an 8.0, or even a 7.0. I think the 8.5 is pretty good. More than enough power, and since it is on the lower turn in comparison to some of the hotter mod motors, it's a little bit easier of a power band to drive, and you can normally compensate for top end with turbo and a lot of the ESC adjustments that we get. Aside from that, the receiver that I run is the Muchmore MRX 482 receiver. This is the wireless Sanwa compatible receiver that I run. It is compatible in SSR mode, which is pretty neat. So you can do the high-speed feedback from the Sanwa radio, and it will work perfectly. So yeah, that's it for as far as my electronics goes, the equipment that I run, stuff like that. All in all, the car's been super good. I've really enjoyed running this new car, putting a lot of time on it so far to get ready for the INS series later in the year. That'll be held at the Hoosier RC Hobbyplex in Indiana. I've been there a few times already in very similar conditions to my home track. It's another sealed high grip clay track. So looking forward to that, putting in some more time with this new car, continuing to get a feel for the new changes, the new parts that are put into this car, and just generate a good, strong base setup for when we head out to INS. So again, thanks everyone for watching. I just wanted to bring in an update video, kind of going over some of the things that I've done to it, some of the things that I run on the car, and just talk about some of the changes that Associated has done to this new car. So yeah, thanks everyone for watching. I know I've been away from posting videos for a little bit. It's been busy, but hopefully we'll be able to bring more videos for you guys here in the future when time allows. So thanks again for watching, and we will see everyone in the next one.